Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this very special event, the occasion when we honor all the artists of this region who have made a name for themselves across the world. The award being given is the Amrita Sher-Gil Samman. The Chandigarh Lalit Kala Akademi prides itself, and justifiably, as I'm sure you would agree, on its continuing efforts to bring art and the best of artists almost to the doorsteps of us Chandigarh citizens. We first present to you a slideshow to give you a glimpse of our art-related endeavors in recent times.
Thank you.
incredible but true that we should be so richly blessed. I now invite Mr. Diwan Manna to introduce the evening to you all.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Honorable Professor B.N. Goswami, and distinguished artists who have contributed to the field of art, who are going to be honored this evening, friends of the Academy, young students of art and art lovers, all of you are very, very welcome to this very special evening, which we have tried to organize after a gap of almost a year and a half. I once again welcome you all, and I thank you that you have always been encouraging and supporting us in whatever we try to do for the promotion, dissemination, and sharing of art amongst the people of this region and maybe the country. The Academy, in fact, by honoring these people who have, as Mrs. Judge has very rightly said, have contributed to the field of art not only here, nationally and internationally, for the last decades. By honoring them, in fact, which is a fact, we all know, we are honoring ourselves. We are very grateful and thankful that these luminaries have accepted our invitation and have made an effort out of their very, very busy schedule, because all of them are very, very preoccupied with whatever they are doing to promote this art, writing on art, curating shows, or doing their own practices. As you all know, last to last year we honored 10 distinguished personalities from the field of art, those who live in Chandigarh, who have actually made this scene happen, because as we know, Chandigarh is a new city. As Dr. Randhawa, with his untiring efforts, made many of them settle down in city, not only made them settle down, gave them land. He bought their work on installments, gave them installments to, have those houses which they were given by them. It was a huge effort on the part of Dr. Randhawa, but again a huge effort on the part of those who settled down here, tried to make the art scene vibrant by their contribution in whichever manner. Some of them may not have achieved that kind of a success which actually reaches out to all of us, but nevertheless their contribution had to be recognized, and the Academy thought it appropriate that we must recognize those who have contributed to the field of art. Had they not been doing this art practice here in this city, the city would not be as receptive to art as it is today. We are very, very thankful to those 10 distinguished personalities who we honored. Again, I would repeat that by honoring them, we honored ourselves. As you all know, through this slideshow, which was very hurriedly put up, we have been trying to, bring the best of the country, best of the world, to this city, so that young students, lovers of art, and those who are seriously involved in the practice and, of course, collecting and appreciating art, get to know. We are trying to create a kind of a knowledge pool with which the city grows. City doesn't grow only in terms of economic and technological power, but city also grows in terms of the soft power. Chandigarh, as we all know, we need not repeat, it's a very, very new city, well-planned city. And as Dr. Goswami was giving an interview that on 14th of this month, he said, this is perhaps the best city to live in the world. This is his statement. He said, it is a city where I can breathe, where I can have space, where I can think. And of course, city being very close to Delhi, we are culturally very, very well connected, and we are well connected in terms of resources, whatever is available in the national capital. Academy again has been doing whatever all the academies do, but we have been a little more particular in terms of a selection, in terms of our research on whom to invite, whom not to invite, whom to provide this platform. You must have heard this about Harvallabh Sangeet Sammelan. Anybody from the field of music, classical music especially, they would vie with each other to be invited to the Harvallabh Sangeet Sammelan. We do not feel that way, you know, egoistic, or we think we have achieved that, that we have achieved this kind of a status in which everybody wants to be here, but we are on the way. It's just a give and take in which we provide that kind of a platform where people are seriously listening to and viewing their artworks. At the same time, those who come, they also get enriched by that, you know, warm response which the Chandigarh audience always gives them. For that, I am really thankful to all of you for very keenly listening and appreciating and viewing works of art, listening to art historians, listening to art critics and curators. I thank you again, and I invite Mrs. Judge to begin the evening of honor giving ceremony. But before that, I will invite Dr. Goswami to kindly join us on the stage so that we can confer these honors on these luminaries. Thank you.
Art, it is said, is for all time. Its beauty and relevance spans across the borders of time and space. Thus, one may gaze with the same wonder as countless others have over ancient Grecian sculptures and Indian miniature paintings, or over multimedia installations and canvases that hold sway in galleries of contemporary art. However, the journeys of exploration into the realms of time and space that their creators belonged to, and the endeavors to understand the nuances of aesthetics, are equally fascinating. This is where art historians such as Dr. Alka Pande step in to illuminate the behind-the-scenes activities and the aesthetic consciousness that led to creations from various lands, cultures, and eras. Currently a consultant arts advisor and curator of the Visual Arts Gallery at the India Habitat Center, New Delhi, Dr. Pandey has been passionately involved with the world of art and art history for nearly three decades. Born in an illustrious family of writers, artists, and academicians, Dr. Pandey imbibed its love of learning and the fine arts. She studied for two postgraduate degrees, history from Bombay University and fine arts from Punjab University, and subsequently, having won the Charles Wallace India Trust Award, she did her postdoc research in critical art theory from the University of London. Her career began with teaching for a number of years at the Department of Fine Arts, Punjab University, and also as director of the Museum of Fine Arts there. She has been a visiting faculty teaching art and aesthetics at Delhi College of Art and the DG Academy of Design, Coimbatore. Dr. Pandey has curated several exhibitions in India and abroad and brought onto the international map some of our most upcoming and influential artists, photographers, and sculptors. Some of her recent special projects have been the Delhi Photo Festival, the Akshara Project, Pageants of the Raj, The Life and Times of Ismat and Manto, Red Strings Through My Hands, and India Awakens Under the Banyan Tree. A prolific writer on Indology and art history, Dr. Pandey has published a wide range of academic papers and lectures and is the author of several well-acclaimed books, some of which have been translated into foreign languages. Her special interest in issues of gender, identity, and ancient Indian erotic literature and art has led to a curated project, the Kama Sutra, Spirituality and Eroticism in Indian Art, that concluded just last week in France. An innovative venture of hers has been the idea of displaying art in public spaces. The India Habitat Center, in collaboration with the Delhi Metro Railway Corporation, has just launched a display of light boxes at the Jorbagh metro station, and at the Mandi House metro station. These exhibitions will run till March 2015, so art lovers travelling to Delhi know where to head. In recognition of Dr. Alka Pande's outstanding contribution, the French government conferred on her the distinction of the Knight of the Order of Arts and Letters in 2006. In 2009, she received the Australian Asia Council Special Award for her contribution to Indian arts. The Chandigarh Lalit Kala Akademi is proud to honour Dr. Pande with the Amrita Sher-Gil Samman. Significantly, she's the only woman amongst its honours list today. May I invite Dr. Alka Pande on stage, please? The earthiness of the rural landscape of Punjab, the collective consciousness of India's spiritual heritage, and the intensely sensitive search for a sense of being and belonging amidst the chaotic Western urban milieu. When these elements come together in an ever-evolving sculpture, you can safely assume that the creative genius of artist Avtarjeet Dhanjal is behind it. When distilled through his consciousness, the contemporaneous and the archaic are forged into new mythical dimensions, carrying within them the seed of his native culture, even as he traverses the lands and cultures of the West. His kinetic sculptures express his exploration and articulation of the human condition. Dhanjal was born in a village in Punjab, where thrived an industry of folk paintings, shrine furniture, and devotional images. He imbibed his father's skills in carpentry and learned to make sign paintings and commemorative figures by observing other village craftsmen. Later, he joined the College of Art here in Chandigarh and discovered sculpture. His first foray, a delicate female form that he carved out of a block of wood, was purchased by this museum. This early success encouraged Dhanjal to explore Indian sculptures and simultaneously evolve his own dialect of form, which culminated in a body of non-figurative kinetic experiments. But then, as restless artists are wont to do, Dhanjal left for East Africa, sketching and selling his way through Malawi, Ethiopia and Zambia in search of fresh horizons. A teaching assignment enabled him to resume his experiments with kinetic sculptures. A one-man show at the Woodstock Gallery in London, a postgraduate course in sculpture at the St. Martin's School of Art, and an industrial sponsorship were followed by a return to his homeland in the late 70s. The visit reawakened in him the quest for his cultural moorings and triggered off questions about his sense of being and belonging. The 80s saw Dhanjal's sculptures receive major critical attention in England in Hayward Gallery's telling of the other story. His ideas blossomed in a series of commissions for environmental sculptures in Slovenia, South Wales, Wolverhampton and Cardiff. The 90s brought a retrospective survey of Dhanjal's work over 25 years and the publication of a monograph. He led a seminar, Shaping Histories, Imagining Futures, at the Intergovernmental Conference on Cultural Policies, organized by UNESCO. For the last decade or so, he has been searching beyond the world of material objects. Dhanjal's interventions in the environment intensify one's presence and sense of self. We, the viewers, complement and complete the sculptural process by our orchestrated, almost ritualistic actions, whether it is to light a candle or walk on paving stones. Thus, we become participants of sort in the creative journey that he has initiated. The Chandigarh Lalit Kala Akademi takes pride in honoring this accomplished artist. May I invite Mr. Avtarjeet Dhanjal on stage, please? Creations from his brush adorn the walls of the banquet hall of the Hotel Oberoi Intercontinental and of 5 metro stations in Delhi. His artwork appears in the form of commemorative postage stamps, such as those released during the Asian Games in 1982. He has designed many catalogues, folders, illustrations for various magazines and books, and notably the logos My Chandigarh and Chandigarh Smoke Free. Yes, Brahm Prakash, the artist, does not limit his creativity to canvases alone. Born in 1950 in Hisar, Haryana, Sri Brahm Prakash received his early education in Secunderabad and Mumbai. He moved to Delhi in the 70s, topping in the BFA painting course he studied at Delhi University, simultaneously training under the distinguished artist Rameshwar Bruta. He joined as teaching faculty at the Government College, Chandigarh in 1976 and worked his way up as head of the Department of Printmaking and Painting. The HRD Ministry, Government of India, awarded him a senior fellowship for research from 1983 to 86 in painting. He was promoted as principal of the college in 2001 and headed the institution for 7 years. To him goes the credit of introducing MFA courses in all the 4 disciplines of painting, sculpture, graphics, and applied art. Sri Brahm Prakash has represented India in various major international art exhibitions since 1975, notably in Australia, France, Japan, Germany, and USA. He has held solo shows at prestigious venues across India and participated in many art camps over the years. Beginning from a special 6-week printmaking workshop organized by the Government College of Art, Chandigarh, in 1976, he has continued to conduct printmaking workshops in different parts of the country. The Josip Broz Tito Art Gallery in Yugoslavia, the National Gallery of Modern Art, New Delhi, National Lalit Kala Academy, New Delhi, the Gallery of Modern Art, Jaipur, the Indo-Gulf Fertilizers and Chemicals, New Delhi, are some of the well-known institutions that house his artworks. Sri Brahm Prakash has received many awards, including the International Award by the National Academy of Art, New Delhi, the National Award by the National Lalit Kala Academy, the W.G. Archer Award for Outstanding Contribution. The Punjab and Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academies have also bestowed honours on him in recognition of his work. Today, once again, the Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy takes pleasure in honouring Sri Brahm Prakash. I'm afraid Sri Brahm Prakash is indisposed today, so he's not been able to attend the event. So we move on now to the next artist, Sri Gurcharan Singh. Art holds a mirror to life, it is said, and life isn't always beautiful, radiant, and happy. Gurcharan Singh, one of the senior-most artists of this region, chooses to bring before us what we would rather avoid or push to the fringes. Tales at Twilight of Les Miserables. The wretchedly poor, the pimps and prostitutes, the teeming multitudes who eke out a hand-to-mouth existence in life's seamy, sordid underbelly, form a telling narrative of the struggle for survival in a world shorn of ideals. Hard-as-nails women, licentious men, and a host of others are juxtaposed with animal figures to create a panorama that is colorful, bizarre, and lusty with life, often blurring the boundaries between man and beast. Painted in garish reds and blues, the expressive faces of these creatures, especially those of women, are deeply moving and poignant. Amongst his most well-known works are Red Light and Black and White and Les Miserables. The 1949-born Gurcharan Singh is an alumnus of the College of Art and Crafts, Chandigarh. Over the years, he has held solo exhibitions in major art galleries in Chandigarh, New Delhi, Mumbai, Paris, and Canada. His works are on display at the Lalit Kala Akademi, New Delhi, National Gallery of Art, New Delhi, and India House, Paris. He was honored with a national award in 1976. Gurcharan Singh's creations have been shown at the International Biennales in Cleveland, Tokyo, and the Soviet Union, at the Contemporary Arts Show in Seoul, as well as at Gallery 7 and Jehangir Art Gallery in Mumbai. He was also one of the six artists who took part in the Festival of Contemporary Art in London's Covent Garden in 1988. More recently, he's participated in group shows titled Sacred and Secular and Black is Beautiful, held at India Fine Art, Mumbai. He's currently working at animation at the Films Division on a film on Nehru. Gurcharan Singh's stark and poignant depictions of the plight of the underprivileged, the invisible, and the exploited have earned him much acclaim, and the Chandigarh Lalit Kala Akademi honors him for his lifelong commitment to art. Since Sri Gurcharan Singh is also indisposed today, his brother, Sri Prem Singh Ji, is here, also another artist who is to be honored today. So he will receive the citation on his behalf. The late Jagmohan Chopra, who passed away in March 2013, has been often referred to as an artist's artist. He was among our country's pioneering printmakers and photographers, much ahead of his time in his artistic impressions. Born in Lahore in 1935, Sri Jagmohan Chopra studied at the Delhi Polytechnic School of Art and then began teaching at the Delhi College of Art in the early 60s. He earned global recognition early, having participated in important art exhibitions in Poland, Manila, Germany, Brazil, Switzerland, etc. His works were also exhibited at the print biennales in Austria, Poland, the Philippines, and notably at five triennales in India, right until the 80s. Besides this, he held numerous solo shows of his paintings and graphics in Delhi over the years. Sri Chopra's consistent qualitative output brought with it accolades and an impressive list of awards, beginning with the Punjab Government Silver Medal and the first prize at the FX Annual in 1959, to a gold medal at the All India Graphics Exhibition in 1965, two national awards by the Lalit Kala Akademi. He went on to being honored by the North Zone Cultural Center, Patiala, in 1987, and received the prestigious Kala Ratna Award by AFAX in 1988. He won international awards from Switzerland in 1968 and from the Philippines in 1969. As a veteran of the arts, Jagmohan Chopra held senior positions in India's major cultural institutions such as the Lalit Kala, IFAX, Shilpi Chakra and the Government Museum at Chandigarh. He was invited as jury member on national and international bodies. Chandigarh is proud to have had a close connection with Sri Chopra. He not only taught at the Government College of Art, but also headed the institution till his retirement in 1992. He was the Vice Chairman, Chandigarh Lalit Kala Akademi, from 1978 to 85, Vice President of the Chandigarh Camera Society, Honorary Secretary, Punjab Lalit Kala Akademi, and also an Executive Committee member of the Punjab Arts Council, Chandigarh. Jagmohan Chopra ji is no longer with us, but he lives on through his numerous artworks in collections in England, the Rashtrapati Bhavan, Raj Nivas, College of Art, National Gallery of Modern Art and Sahitya Kala Parishad in Delhi. The Hyderabad State Museum, the Baroda University Fine Arts Faculty, Banaras Hindu University, Jaipur's Museum of Modern Art and in the Chandigarh Museum and Art Gallery. The Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy pays tribute to this venerable artist today.
Professor Chopra's daughter, Mrs. Nina Pathak, is amongst us today to receive this honor on his behalf.
Mrs. Nina Pathak. The inexhaustible resource of nature, its divine and celestial chorus that casts its magical spell on the human mind, is his muse. Says he, "My paintings reflect on the playful and prayerful moments that I experience through my dialogue with the manifest and the unmanifest in nature. I am like a bird that can fly free through line, form and color." Through his creative expression, Prem Singh, the artist, seeks to capture nature's silent magnificence, experienced only through moments of meditation. Votaries of art can gain a glimpse of this silent, contemplative artistic expression through Sri Prem Singh's prolific output, housed in collections across the country. Prominent amongst these are the National Gallery of Modern Art, Rashtrapati Bhavan, and AFAX at New Delhi, the NZCC, the Birla Academy of Art and Culture, Kolkata, Society for the Protection of Cultural Heritage, Trivandrum, the State Museum, Chennai, Jamia Millia, Kurukshetra, Maharishi Dayanand, Punjab and Punjabi universities, and Lalit Kala Academies of various states. Patiala was the birthplace and academic training ground for the 1943-born Prem Singh, who won a gold medal from Punjabi University, Patiala, for his Master's in Fine Arts. An earlier 5-year stint at the College of Art and then principalship there formed his Chandigarh connection. From the 70s to the present day, Sri Prem Singh's artistic journey is dotted with solo and group exhibitions in the country and across foreign shores. Among the long lineup of his solo shows stand out 6 at the Taj Art Gallery, Mumbai, 5 at the Triveni Kala Sangam, New Delhi, 3 at the Fine Arts Museum, Punjab University, and then at Shilpi Chakra, Habitat Center, New Delhi, Academy of Fine Arts, Kolkata, and the Contemporary Art Gallery, Ahmedabad. His paintings have shared space at exhibitions in Cuba, Mexico, Dhaka, UK, and of course, in India. Paintings seems to come as naturally to Sri Prem Singh as breathing, and so he continues to vivify his canvases, responding as a sensitive artist would to contemporary social issues. 2014 saw him participating in 3 group exhibitions, one on environment at AFX, another titled Nirbhay, and a third in the International Art Festival at the National Gallery, Maldives. Awards have been a natural corollary, with honours being bestowed on him by the Punjab Lalit Kala Akademi, the Triennale India International Award, and Your Studio Award by the Saatchi Gallery, London. The Punjab government awarded him a Praman Patra in 2011, and he was bestowed the title of Punjab Kala Ratan by the Punjab Lalit Kala Akademi, Chandigarh, last year. Today, the Chandigarh Lalit Kala Akademi is proud to honour Shri Prem Singh for his dedication to art. May I invite Shri Prem Singh on stage, please? A bench in a park, bedecked with twirling fronds of creepers. Dark clouds looming mysteriously over the horizon. Flowers dancing in gay abandon. A rainbow enlivening a dull sky. Paper boats skimming riskily over swirling eddies. As one gazes at the canvases, illuminating an interplay of depth and light and inviting contemplation, one is struck by the irony that their curator belonged to an artist's group called the Unknown. For could such art and such an artist ever remain unknown? It wasn't long before the name of Raj Kumar Jain created a buzz in North India's art circles. This Kota-born artist, who had studied for a diploma in fine art at the Delhi Polytechnic in 1961, was seen exhibiting his works in important group exhibitions and holding his solo shows in Chandigarh, Patiala, and Delhi through the 60s and 70s. His reputation as an artist with affiliation to modernism was soon established as he traversed the twin tracks of Impressionism and Expressionism, experimenting with form, color, and structure. Prominent amongst his exhibitions are the Third Triennale Indian Exhibition at Delhi in 1974, the Young Artists Workshop in Chandigarh in 1974, the annual Punjab Lalit Kala Exhibitions over 3 decades, the North Zone Cultural Festivals, the Chandigarh Museum's exhibitions, the Punjab Lalit Kala Academy's travelling exhibitions, the Chandigarh Artists Exhibitions in 1991, and the 11th Triennale India in 2005. Raj Jain has also made an impact at numerous art camps that he has attended over the years, especially those organized by the NZCC, the Lalit Kala Academies of Punjab and Chandigarh, and AFEX. He has been honored by AFEX, the Chandigarh and Punjab Lalit Kala Academies, the College of Art Chandigarh, and most recently by the Delhi Art College. The Gateway Art Centre at Shrewsbury, UK, also telecast a film on his art and life. As a teacher at the art department of the Triveni Kala Sangam, Delhi, and later as an assistant professor in painting at the Government College of Art, Chandigarh, for over 2 decades, and then at schools in UK, Raj Jain has honed the skills of many students. He continues to paint. So if you come across kites playfully flying across canvases or a flute player etched with superb skill, you'll know that it comes from the brush of the artist who once, surely tongue-in-cheek, belonged to a group called the Unknown. The Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy honors the creator of these nostalgia-filled canvases today. May I invite Shri Raj Jain on stage, please?
Thank you.
He's unique. He was always very different. His work was special, even in his college days, is how some of his contemporaries refer to artist Ranbir Kaleka. His art defies simple slotting in. One can imagine this Patiala-born lad stirring up the artscape of Chandigarh in the early 70s as a student here, and then as a teacher at an affiliated college of the Punjabi University, Patiala. He taught for about 5 years at the Delhi College of Art, too, moving to foreign shores on a scholarship to do his master's at the Royal College of Art in London in 1985. Honours came early to Ranbir Kaleka, with the National Award from the Lalit Kala Akademy in 1979 and the Sanskriti Award in 1986. His works have achieved worldwide recognition and acclaim through exhibitions, too numerous to mention here, in museums, galleries, and biennales in Sydney, New York, Vancouver, Moscow, Vienna, Milan, Venice, Taiwan, Korea, Tokyo, and Bangkok, apart from being lauded in Delhi, Mumbai, and Chennai. In the past 5 years alone, his works have been showcased in over 40 exhibitions all over the world, the most recent being in USA, Korea, Switzerland, Singapore, and Delhi. His forthcoming shows are slated for the Jewish Museum, New York, and a traveling exhibition organized by the National Gallery of Modern Art, India, at Shanghai. Art critics admire Kaleka's work for celebrating the poetics of the liminal moment, the elusive spatial and temporal terrain wherein the self stands poised to transform itself. His painted images are deftly juxtaposed with projections, creating an effect of deceptive stability through which he explores the subtleties of space, time, sensation, and significance. The focus on the precarious quality of the image invites reflections on questions about the nature of individual subjectivity and everyday experience, with its tangled web of dream, delusion, and reverie, making traverse varying levels of consciousness. At times, his works seem to resonate with the Sanskrit concept of Leela, in which the world is seen as a continual unfolding and play of appearances. When does a picture change to being a scene or a film narrative? Kaleka says, "I don't look for what is possible in cinema. I know what I want, and in the process, I may tweak cinema to achieve it." The Chandigarh Lalit Kala Akademi felicitates this artist's virtuosity and persistent questioning of the boundaries of different art mediums and honors him today with the Amrita Sher-Gil Samman. Signboard painter, fresco maker, thanka artist, Madhubani painter, papier-mâché craftsman, sculptor, documentary filmmaker, writer, music composer, house designer, polyglot. Sidharth is all these and much more. Early inculcation by his mother into a spiritual consciousness of nature and divinity turned the 1956-born Harjinder Singh towards creative pursuits. His is a tale of one life, many masters, in his quest for self-identity and the ultimate artistic expression. While his mother, fashioning a brush from a wad of cotton twisted deftly onto a twig, may have been his first teacher, local artisans near his village in Punjab trained him to paint signboards, murals, and friezes. The venerated artist Sobha Singh became his next master. The meditative, intricately detailed Thangka paintings by Tibetan Buddhist monks attracted him too, and he not only learned the highly esoteric art from them, but also took on a new name and persona as Sidharth. Then came a 5-year stint of study at the College of Art in Chandigarh. During this period, he travelled extensively in Punjab, studying folk motifs and honing his skills as well as artistic sensibilities. His first significant award came in 1979 from the Punjab Lalit Kala Akademi for his painting White Space, and then for Green Dog. In 1982, Sidharth joined an advertising agency in Delhi as a visualizer, and then the Crafts Museum at Pragati Maidan as an exhibition officer. This brought him into contact with many craftspersons from diverse regions of India, from whom he learnt their crafts and made his first foray into filmmaking with a documentary on Sita Devi, a Madhubani artist. His first solo show of pencil and oil drawings on paper, titled Self Clowns, was put up at Triveni Gallery, New Delhi, and since then there's been no looking back. He has held 23 solo shows and has participated in 135 group shows and international art fairs in India, Dubai, UK, Sweden, USA, Singapore, Korea, and Hong Kong. Experimentation seems to be Sidharth's hallmark, as the diverse nature of his exhibitions indicate. Pen and pencil drawings, china glass marking on plastic paper, impasto oil paintings, gouache on paper, egg tempera on wasli paper, watercolors, miniature formats, installations. He's done them all, winning accolades all the way. He's also worked with mineral colors and vegetable dyes, grinding, distilling, and processing natural materials to yield the essence of their hue. Stories, poetry, music, all contribute to my aesthetics, says Sidharth. He likes to chant and sing aloud while painting, which for him is a ritual meditative act. Artists, art critics speak appreciatively of the subtle quietude and a sense of hard-won peace that his works exude, especially the reflective dreamlike Baramaha series. His works have been acquired by the Indian Government Museum, the British Council in Delhi, the Punjab Lalit Kala Academy, the British, Mexican and Swedish ambassadors, the Dusseldorf Museum in Sweden, and several industrial groups in India and abroad. The Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy is pleased to honor Sri Sidharth today with the Amrita Sher-Gil Samman. I invite Sri Sidharth, please. A patriarchal Haryanvi family on the one hand, and a feisty, supportive mother and wife on the other. Luckily for the young lad dreaming of pigments and artscapes, the latter one, and the artist in Virendar Singh, Tanwar, was realized. A diploma in drawing and painting from the Government College of Art, Chandigarh, 1974, and a British Council scholarship to study at the Slade School of Arts, London, in 84-85, were Viren Tanwar's training grounds. Serendipitous opportunities further came his way in the form of mentoring and support from stalwarts like M.S. Randhawa, Professor B.N. Goswami, Dr. Alka Pande, and R.K. Jain. Beginning with the first prize at the annual art exhibition for 4 consecutive years at the Government College of Art, Chandigarh, Viren Tanwar moved on to collect numerous state and national awards, notable among them being the awards from the Punjab and Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academies, the All India Art Exhibition, AFAX, and the Dr. M.S. Randhawa Memorial Award instituted by AFAX Delhi. He has been honoured with the title of Kala Shri by AFAX and the Kala Bhumi Samman by HIFA Haryana. Shri Tanwar has participated in dozens of group shows and art camps in India and New Zealand, Singapore, Berlin, Mexico, New Zealand, New York, Vienna, London, etc. He has held solo shows of his work in Chennai, Chandigarh, Mumbai, Delhi and Singapore. His paintings grace numerous private and public collections, notably those of the Peabody Essex Museum, USA, the SI Museum, Austria, the Museum of Sacred Art, Belgium, the Chester and Devida Hurwitz Collection, USA, Icon Gallery in London and New York. Closer home, his works are on display at the National Gallery of Modern Art and the National Lalit Kala Akademy at Delhi, the Rorik Museum in Himachal Pradesh, the Raj Bhavans of Punjab and Haryana, the Fine Arts Museums of Punjab and Punjab University, and in collections of TISCO, NZCC, etc. As Secretary, Punjab Lalit Kala Academy, Vice Chairman and Secretary, Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy, General Council Member, National Lalit Kala Academy, and Member Programme Committee of the NZCC Patiala, at different periods of time, Shri Tanwar has contributed significantly to promote art in the region. In recognition of his merit and services to the world of art, the Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy honours him today. May I invite Shri Virendar Tanwar on stage, please. And now it is time for us to invite Professor B.N. Goswami to please speak on this occasion.
अगर बहुत कई नुक्ता निगाह से देखा जाए तो मैं अधिकारी नहीं हूँ यहाँ पे होने का कई वजह से मेरी जगह पे बहुत सामान्य चित्रकार कृष्ण खन्ना आने वाले थे लेकिन उनकी तबीयत नासाज हो गई तो मुझे उन्होंने कहा दीवान ने कहा तो इसलिए मैं यहाँ पे हूँ लेकिन एक तरीके से देखा जाए तो कुछ मुनासिबत भी इसमें है क्योंकि आई हैव द प्लेजर ऑफ नोइंग पर्सनली जस्ट अबाउट एवरी सिंगल पर्सन हु हैज रिसीव्ड an award this evening. And it's a great pleasure, a truly a great pleasure to be here and be a part of the wonderful ceremony of honoring gifted people. Kaha jata hai ki jab shahar mein jaan nahi hoti hai to takleef hoti hai. और जब शहर में जान आ जाती है तो सेलिब्रेट करने का मन करता है और अब सब जो हैं फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम अलका पांडे अवतारजीत जी देन जगमोहन जी प्रेम सिंह राज साहब रणबीर वीरेन सिद्धार्थ जो नहीं रहे हमारे पास जो जगमोहन जी हैं थे उनका दुख होता है उनको याद करके जो नहीं आ सके तो अफसोस होता है कि वो नहीं आ सके लेकिन निहायत उम्दा बात है कि किस सलीके से किस सम्मान के साथ और किस एफिशिएंसी से और किस एक तरह से जो दिल से बात निकलती है असर रखती है तो दीवान ने और ललित कला एकेडमी ने ये सब अरेंज किया तो आई एम ग्रेटफुल आई एम पर्सनली वेरी ग्रेटफुल दैट ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द सिटी ऑफ चंडीगढ़ we had had the sense to honor distinguished people such as yourselves. कहा जाता है कि टीएस एलियट का है, मेरा शब्द नहीं है, मेरा वाक्य नहीं है. उन्होंने कहा है कि बिटवीन द कंसेप्शन एंड द क्रिएशन देयर फॉल्स अ शैडो, बिटवीन द थॉट एंड द डीड देयर फॉल्स अ शैडो. तो बिटवीन द कंसेप्शन एंड द क्रिएशन जो शैडो गिरता है, कई केसेस में गहरा होता है, कई केसेस में धुंधला होता है, लेकिन होता है. और जब कोई उसको उस शैडो को हटा देता है और कंसेप्शन और क्रिएशन जब मिल जाते हैं, फ्यूज हो जाते हैं, तो ग्रेट आर्ट इज बॉर्न. तो माय कन्विक्शन इज कि सब दोस्त जिनको ऑनर किया गया है यहाँ पे, दे हैव वर्क्ड एक्सट्रीमली हार्ड टू रिमूव दैट शैडो विच फॉल्स बिटवीन कंसेप्शन एंड क्रिएशन, एंड दे डिजर्व not only our congratulations but our grateful thanks for having done that and for having achieved that. Van Gogh ne kaha tha kahin ek chitthi mein apne bhai se likha tha usne ki jab main sochta hu koi cheez aur jab main karna chahta hu to mujhe lagta hai ki between us there is a steel wall, really a wall of steel, जिसको मैं एक छोटी सी रेती से लेकर के रगड़ रहा हूँ कि शायद इसमें कोई छेद आ जाए, शायद मैं पार देख सकूँ, उस पार जा भी सकूँ. अब अंदाज़ा लगाइए कि दुनिया, ये लोहे का चना है जो चबा रहे हैं ये सब लोग, कुछ चबा चुके हैं, कुछ अभी तक मुंह में रखा हुआ पान की गिलौरी की तरह, और कईयों ने उसको बाहर निकालने की कोशिश की लेकिन वो जाता नहीं है, वो चना वहीं रहता है. तो मैं ये समझता हूँ कि ये जो आपने संयोजन किया है, ललित कला एकेडमी ने जो कुछ कर रहे हैं ये किया है, वो इन जवान बच्चों के लिए, लड़के लड़कियों के लिए जो यहाँ पढ़ते हैं, उनके लिए सबसे ज़्यादा अहमियत रखता है. क्योंकि दिस जनरेशन इज, माई जनरेशन तो मेरी बात ही छोड़िए, दिस जनरेशन इज ऑन द पॉइंट ऑफ, इज हैविंग रीच्ड अ पॉइंट बियॉन्ड विच द टॉर्च हैज़ टू बी कैरिड ऑन, बियॉन्ड विच हमें और आगे बढ़ना है. वो बड़ा घिसा पटा शेर है, लेकिन आपने सुना होगा कि मैं अकेला ही चला था जानबे मंजिल मगर, लोग साथ आते गए और कारवां बनता गया. तो जिस तरह एकेडमी ने ये सब कुछ किया है, जिस तरह यहाँ के कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट ने किया है, जिस तरह यहाँ के म्यूज़ियम ने किया है, जिस तरह यहाँ के शहर ने किया, वो जिम्मेवारी अब आपकी है. आप बैठे हैं, सुन रहे हैं, देख रहे हैं, और इससे ज़्यादा ये एकेडमी कुछ नहीं कर सकती कि एक चिराग हाथ में लेकर आपको दिखाए कि रास्ता इस तरफ है. I truly appreciate the fact कि आप लोगों ने तकलीफ़ उठाई, यहाँ पे आए, हमें मौका दिया कि हम आपका सम्मान कर सकें. और मैं दीवान मन्ना और चंडीगढ़ ललित कला अकेडमी के सब साथियों का बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूँ कि उन्होंने मुझे कहा कि मैं यहाँ पे आऊँ एंड बी ए पार्टिसिपेंट इन दिस सेरेमनी ऑफ इनोसेंस, इसको कहते हैं. वो आपको मुबारक हो, आपका बहुत शुक्रिया. और इट्स टाइम टू सेलिब्रेट. ये बताएंगे कि चाय है बाहर, लेकिन टाइम टू सेलिब्रेट इन मेनी वेज, मोर देन वन वे, कि ये शहर में आपने चार चांद लगाए, आपने शहर को एक एजाज़ बख्शा है, जिसके लिए मैं पर्सनली और बाकी सब साथी बहुत ममनून है, बहुत शुक्रगुजार है. क्या कहते हैं कि इस मौके को भूलना नहीं चाहिए. हर एक याद जो हम संजोते हैं, जो हम इकट्ठी करते हैं, इट बिकम्स अ पार्ट ऑफ आवर लाइव्स. एवरी टाइम यू मीट अ ग्रेट पर्सन, मीट अ ग्रेट आर्टिस्ट, मीट अ डिस्टिंग्विश्ड personality, मुझे है मेरे टीचर ने कहा था यू आर बॉर्न अ लिटिल एवरी टाइम यू डू दैट तो लेट्स रिमेंबर दिस कि व्हेन वी मीट ग्रेट आर्टिस्ट वेदर दे आर हियर और एल्सवेयर वी आर बॉर्न अ लिटिल और अगर हमारे हाथों में वो रेती हो जिसके फान गोख ने जिक्र किया है तो उस रेती को इस्तेमाल करें मे आई थैंक यू वेरी मच इंडीड थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग हियर
Thank you, Professor Goswami, for your gracious presence here today and for your words that are always illuminating and always inspiring. May I request our chairman, Mr. Diwan Manna, to formally present the vote of thanks.
Friends, you all know, after Professor Goswami, who is willing to listen to me? But I happen to be in this position where I think I'm required to thank you all. First of all, I thank Professor Goswami for having agreed at the last moment when Krishna Kannaji was very, very apologetically calling me again and again and saying, Divan, because he has a swollen foot. He could not even move out of his chair or bed. Otherwise, he was all willing to come. His doctor advised him not to go. His hand was broken. In spite of that, he agreed to come. But when his foot got swollen, he said on my behalf, kindly apologize to all the distinguished personalities who are going to be honored, and also to the art-loving public of Chandigarh. So I pass on his message to all of you. His apologies. And we are actually grateful to him that he had agreed to come, and more grateful to Professor Goswami, not only because he has agreed. He said one thing very special to me. He said, Divan, I do not mind that I've been called at the last moment, that somebody else's name is printed on the card. I do not have that issue at all. I am with the Academy, I am with the artists, and all the artists we have selected are worthy names of being honored. My only reservation is that most of them are my colleagues, and they may not feel that honored from me as they would have probably, you know, by some bureaucrat or somebody else. Then I said, Prasad, aapke samne hum kisi bhi bureaucrat ko le aayenge, kya wo izzat, wo maan aap hum sabko de payenge? In fact, we are grateful that you have agreed to come. Thank you so much. Then I thank the Chandigarh administration for providing this space to all of us as any autonomous body in the country should, without interfering in our activities, letting us do what we think as professionals, as responsible citizens, as people who really mean business of deciding who the people are, to be honored, to be given awards, to be given fellowships and scholarships, whom to invite, what to do, as any autonomous institution should be. Then I am thankful to this museum. Unfortunately, the director is not here today. She is on leave. To the director personally, to the secretary culture, the director culture, and the director of the museum, and their staff, which has untiringly, unfailingly, without any questions, been supportive of us, because we as yet do not have an office, which is a proper office where we could hold our things. But in fact, we have usurped the space of the museum. It is known more for academy activities these days, just due to because of their generosity, they open their doors to us. Then I'm thankful to some of the individuals, especially Mr. Sunil from the museum, who has wholeheartedly supported us, not because of the fact that he's an employee of the museum, but because he believes in what we are doing. Then I'm thankful to Parul, who has helped us, and her sister Payal. Then I'm thankful to our general counsel. Our members have been very supportive of the executive committee. And I'm thankful to the general counsel for the fact that they have decided to honor the distinguished personalities with full support, without any, you know, questions. I'm thankful to our vice chairman, Mr. though I should not, He is my colleague and a friend, Madan Lal and Bhim Malhotra. They have also been a great support in whatever we try to do in the academy. Defi Brad is not here today. She has also been very active, and especially Anu Grewal. She was somewhere here. Then I would like to thank, in fact, all of you would probably like to thank Mrs. Iqbal Judge. You know our oratory and oratorial skills. You very well know. Any artist, you know, whatever he can, she can do. But for her, we would not be really able to give this kind of a graciousness to the ceremony if she were not there to help us. Thank you so much, Iqbalji, really from the bottom of my heart. I thank the citizens of Chandigarh for their wholehearted support to us. In the last 6-7 years, we have been really able to make a change which we wanted to make. But there are a lot of things which we have not really been able to do, which we should have done, which we wanted to do. But as you know, there are always some limitations. Not limitations of only funds or resources, but there can be limitations of our thought also. We are also human beings. We may not have been able to think of those things which we should have done. Your suggestions are always welcome. Whatever we, within our limited resources, mental, intellectual, and other resources, we would love to incorporate your suggestions into our future programs. Now, all these distinguished personalities, as Dr. Goswami said, I have had the privilege of knowing all of them. I have been a student of many of them, and then became a friend of some of them after being their students. Then Dr. Alka Pande have had a close relationship, professional as well as at many other levels. And Sidharth has been my senior in College of Art. We were friends even in college. I know most of the family members of all of you, but I must say that these relationships, these friendships, these student-teacher relationships have had no role to play in selecting them for the honorship, being honored. It is the collective decision of the General Council. It is not my decision. And I really feel thankful to you. It is, as he said, it's a very nostalgic kind of moment in my life and many of others' lives. I know there are a lot of people sitting in the audience who have just come to meet each one of you or some of you. Some of you have touched as a good teacher, as a good friend. You have promoted them somewhere. You have given them some, you know, pearls of wisdom or some technical support somewhere. That's why this hall is full today, because they knew there's not going to be any particular slideshow or presentation of art, but honors. And sometimes we have seen auditoriums being empty when people are being honored. It is because of your contribution to the city and to the field of art, not only here, in the rest of the country, that these people have that respect and love and affection for you from the bottom of their heart. They're here. I've seen many of them hugging you, touching your feet, and some of them who are not here, I know that they wanted to be here, but they're not here because of certain genuine reasons. I'm really obliged, really thankful to you that you have accepted this honor. I will once again repeat, in fact, by honoring you, we have, you know, अपने आप को खुद ही हमने एक थापी दी है आपके सपोर्ट से आपके कंधे पे रख के हम बंदूक चला रहे हैं अगर आप हमारे साथ ना हो तो हम कुछ नहीं हैं रियली हम कुछ नहीं हैं आई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द जनरल काउंसिल ऑफ द चंडीगढ़ ललित कला एकेडमी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द चंडीगढ़ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कल्चर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू द सिटीजन ऑफ चंडीगढ़ थैंक ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर कमिंग इन हियर